I am back again with another team guide, this time Borussia Dortmund. Everybody loves this club, from their wacky lightning kit to their star players, Erling Haaland and Jadon Sancho. There's a lot to like about this club. One thing is they've got Bayern Munich. Bayern Munich is the one thing stopping this team from being one of the best in the world, probably. We are going to look at this team to see if we can get a tactic that'll work for them, look at some of their key players, and just delve deeper into this squad. For the past two seasons, this team has finished second. Again, the media prediction is getting them second again. I think with Haaland leading this team, Jadon Sancho as well, they can do better than that. They can definitely do better than that. Finances at this club are very healthy indeed. 18 million in the bank, got a wage budget of 2.2 million, and a transfer budget of just under 10 million. And the projection of this club is extremely healthy. At the end of the season, expected to have 100 million in the bank. And the end of next season, 150. So, the players. We all know about Haaland. He is probably one of the best strikers, if not the best striker on the game. He is marvellous. He just seems to know where the goal is. Look at him. 18 finishing, 18 off the ball. Physicals are really good as well. 18 pace. He's got 16 strength. Got to love the 16 composure. Just a brilliant striker. 20 years old, still has room to grow. What more can you say about this kid? Jadon Sancho, another kid, again 20 years old. A wonderful inverted winger or inside forward. 18 dribbling, 16 first touch, 17 technique, 16 flair with 16 decisions, 17 acceleration, 18 pace. He's just wonderful. I used him in my beta save with Man United. It'll cost you a lot of money to get him, but he's brilliant. He is brilliant. Hummels, the experience at the back, the calm, cool, collected head in defence, 16 heading, 16 passing, 17 tackling, 15 marking, 18 positioning, almost a perfect defender, it's just he can't run very fast, 9 acceleration and 8 pace, but everything else is brilliant. Marco Reus, Mr. Dortmund himself, again another really nice player, 31 years old, he is getting on a bit, lots of nice attributes there, 17 finishing, and an 18 off the ball. They're always nice things to see. They have another youngster in their ranks, Giovanni Reina. He can develop into such a wonderful player. He's only 17 years old, the American. What's not to like at this age? 15 dribbling, 15 first touch, 15 work rate, 15 off the ball, natural centre mid and attacking midfielder positions. Loads of potential, another great youngster that this team has. This team seems to just stockpile youngsters, I think. Jude Bellingham, another 17 year old, from Birmingham, just signed for Dortmund, another English player with bags of potential, loads of great attributes to start off with. A lot of his key attributes are already in the double digits. A lot of 13s, a lot of 14s. He's got all the foundations of a player that you can just mould into this world-class beast. So I know Dortmund usually play a 3 at the back system. I have went with something different. I've gone for a 4-3-3 with two wing-backs and a deep-lying playmaker. This is what I've kind of come up with. I think would be quite good for Dortmund. You've got Hummels as the ball playing defender, Zagadou beside him, Witsel as a deep lying playmaker, Guerrero and Meunier as complete wingbacks, getting those guys forward to create opportunities in the middle for Haaland. Emre Can as an attacking playmaker, Brandt as a Mazzala on attack. We have Sancho on the left as an inside forward on attack duties, and on the right we have Reus as a Rundeuter, because you have to use the German role if you're in Germany. And the star of the squad, Haaland up top, advance forward. One of the key things about this tactic is I've only got a standard defensive line. Hummels is not the quickest, Zagadou is acceleration is a bit lacking, so we start with those guys further back. There's less space to be exploited by the opposition. Same as always, I'll leave a download link to the description. I'll leave a link to the download in the description, and if you do try it out, let me know how you get on with it. Now I'm going to sim a season and we'll find out how it gets on. So Borussia Dortmund won the league by 16 points, not losing a single game, winning 22 and drawing 12. Haaland getting 30 goals in the league and Marco Reus getting 10 assists. 84 goals scored by this team in the season, which has them in first place. And with 33 goals conceded, we are third in the rankings. So Haaland played 51 games, 2 as a sub, scoring 43 goals across the entire season. Marco Reus, 17 goals, 15 assists. Jadon Sancho, 14 goals, 13 assists. Jude Bellingham, 9 goals, 10 assists. So you can see here that the focal point of this team is most definitely Haaland. So how did the team get on in the other competitions? So Champions League was knocked out in the semi-final against PSG, and in the cup they were knocked out by SPVGG Greuther Fürth. Anyway, they got to the semi-final of the cup as well. So two semi-final appearances, unbeaten in the league. Finances, the overall balance is now 139 million, and we have a transfer budget of 94 million. So this Dortmund team can be really successful. One of the main things is you've got to keep hold of Haaland and Sancho and all the other youngsters. Brilliant team. Really enjoyed creating a tactic for this team, actually. And if you do try the tactic out, let me know. If you want to see more, remember to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. And I'll catch you guys in another video. And cheerio.